Welcome back. Today we got Dez Green. Been on here before. He's getting ready to fight Kurt Holobaugh coming up here in Titan Fighting Championships 33, March 20th. Mobile, Alabama, can be seen on CBS Sports. Kurt's on a, what's he now, on a four-fight win streak, five-fight win streak? You're coming off a two.
I think it was a four. Yeah.
This is a big fight. I mean, this is a featherweight championship fight for Titan. And they got two of the best, you know, two of the best guys outside of the, you know, outside the UFC fighting for this championship. This is a big deal. I already interviewed Kurt, and he said he's having to do a lot of work on how to stop you from grinding him up, trying to take him down all the time, you know, leaning against him against the fence, like doing a lot of stuff to keep you off, a lot of wrestling defense, which is what we all know anybody that's going to fight you has to do. So it's not any special game plan. But what are you doing differently? Because a lot of your fights kind of look like the same. You do a lot of the same stuff every single fight, but it works. So it's you know, it's almost like if it's not broke, why fix it kind of thing. The only thing that was broke that you had to move up to Montreal and start training, get out of a garage and train at a real training camp, and you did that. And other than that, they really haven't changed much. Is there anything else that you're doing that we haven't really seen yet? It's because you haven't been able to be able to show us in your fights?
Yeah. Since I first started doing this MMA after 2012, I've been working on my stand-up. You know, just me being a good wrestler, I know I'm having to work on my stand-up. So, you know, I've been working on my stand-up for quite some time. Since I moved up here, it's gotten a lot better. And like you said, it's not broke, don't fix it. You know, I can stand, you know, I got great hands. I'm quick. Guys don't really hit me. You know, I feel like I can stand with a lot of people in the division. But it just so happens when, you know, when that bell rings, you know, opportunity for a takedown. It's kind of like second nature. Like, a lot, it's funny, like, the fight with Styler, because, you know, guys, they study me. They know I'm going to go take them down. So, you know, I expect for them to, you know, throw up some good defenses. So I was actually working with a lot of stand-up with Kruash, my Muay Thai coach, and, you know, a lot of elbows and knees. And, you know, I didn't have to show it off just yet, you know. So, like you said, I'm like, you know, if it's not broke, don't fix it. So, and so until someone learns how to stop the takedowns, you know, if those opportunities keep popping up, you know, it's like second nature. You know, sometimes I'll be out there, I want to strike with a guy, and then, as you know, I'm in a double. I didn't even know I shot a double, but we're on the ground and I'm on top. I'm like, oh, well, fuck it. I might as well stay here. You know what I mean? But what we have been working on is some more vicious ground and pound. Faraz has actually, he's actually been really working on me these last couple of weeks on positioning myself. You know, he said the same thing you said. He's like, you know, most of your fights, you're going to end up on top. You know, so now let's try to capitalize on it. So I've definitely been working on, you know, some finishing ground and pound. And really, I actually do want to stand more. You know, hopefully Kurt does his homework and learns how to stop some takedowns and will force me to stand up. But, you know, if not, you know, I'm not going to give him an easy fight by making him stand up, you know.
Yeah, it's one of those things that now – really, MMA has changed. We're seeing a lot of it now, even more so, where it used to be very specific in the beginning. It was jiu-jitsu versus karate versus boxing. And then the middle group, everyone got really good at everything. And now we're starting to see guys go back to being specific again, but it's different than it was in the beginning. In the beginning, they were specific because that's all they know. Now, guys are specific because they're really good at every place else too, but that's just the one place that they really want to be great at. Like, talk about Anderson Silva. He is a really good jiu-jitsu guy off his back. He's got, you know, super high-level submission game, but we never really see it because he's always knocking guys out on his feet because he's a striking guy. That's how we kind of see him, but he's really good everywhere. You're kind of that same athlete where you're really good everywhere. It just happens to be you end up wrestling all the time and end up taking guys down. But sometimes the fans will say that your fights are boring because you take a guy down, you lay on top of him, and you beat him up, but you're not really finishing him. You're not really hurting him a lot. You're kind of just getting on top of him, kind of hanging out. Other than the Miguel Torres fight just a little bit ago, you knocked him you hit him in the face with a knee. That was back in October 2014, I believe. You kind of have a slower pace when you're on top of somebody because you grind them out a little bit. You're saying you're trying to work on some stronger ground and pound. Is that partly because Faraz wants you to have a better way to finish, or partly because the fans are kind of getting in your head as well that, like, hey, I got to be a little bit more exciting if I want to start selling some more T-shirts and make more sponsors want to come my way?
Yeah, no, the fans don't really have too much say. Most of my fans, You know, they love my fights. You know, it's only really the guys that don't really know MMA that wanted to go out there and both have bloodied eyes and bloody noses, and they don't really know the sport. You know, that they want, they're like, oh, it's boring. But you know, any MMA amateur like guys, you know, my fights are, you know, I usually get the feedback on them. You know, I don't like to think of myself as like somebody that likes to go out there and lay on top of the guys. Like, you know, a lot of my fights are like up down. You know, when I'm on top, you know, I do what I can. But you know, any MMA guy knows it's kind of hard, especially nowadays, hard to actually land some decent ground. Because you got guys with so many different tricky guards. Now you got rubber guards, you got ankle locks, so you got to be a lot more cautious. So you know, at the end of the day, a fan may say it's a boring fight, but they only remember wins and losses. So you know, I just try to make sure I stay winning, and you know, everything else will come with it. You know, like I said, maybe just being more comfortable in the cage, it just open up more opportunities for me to open up out there. But yeah, I definitely think, you know, my ground and pound for finishing is more just for me finishing my fight so I could be out there in less time and taking less damage. That's really why I want to finish them.
You know, and that's the problem with MMA. The explosion has been so big, especially with the addition of Titan Fighting Championships on CBS Sports, that the majority of fans now don't really understand mixed martial arts. They're brand new to the fight game. So they're watching something, and they're typical Americans. They want to see somebody get knocked out and get, like you said, somebody with bloody eyes and a bloody nose. They don't really understand how difficult it is to take somebody down, especially like a guy like Kurt Holobov. If you take down your opponent and you're able to grind him out and beat him up on top while you take him down all the time, that's a huge, you know, a huge feat because he is so good at what he does. He's absolutely amazing at staying away and running away and being in that game. So it's gonna be this fight is a great fight. The only thing that concerns me, it's a 5-round fight. It's 25 minutes. You know, add, you know, 30 minutes or 30, 29 minutes if you add in the minute break in between each round. And the CBS card is only 2 hours long. There's four fights on this card that are all title fights. It could go long. It could go deep. Are you feeling any extra pressure to go, look, you got to finish this fight. You got to get out of here early because we want to stay on time. Do you get any pressure like that at all?
No, not really. You know, I think more about there. I actually want to finish this fight anyway, just for you know, for me and just for the rest of the featherweight division. Right now, I feel like a lot of guys are they want the title right now, 45, and I think they're eager to fight me. But I just want to let guys know, like, nothing's coming this way except for a loss. So, you know, I really want to make a statement, but as far as the time is concerned, no, it doesn't really matter. You know, like, it takes 25 minutes to get them out or five. You know, the mission at hand is always to get the win, and then also, you know, to be an entertainer. So, you know, I definitely want to go out there, get the fans what they want, or stand up, you know. But like I said, at the end of the day, if I take them down and it's easy and he's not getting up, I'm not gonna give him a freebie just because a couple fans want to see a knockout, you know?
Yeah, no, you definitely gotta make sure you get that win. It's the most important thing. Are you having fun in Montreal? Like, do you like it up there? Because it's a training camp place for you. So you're going up there, you're hanging out at TriStar, you've got great training partners, obviously a great coach in Faraz, and then, but every time you go up there, it's a miserable time for you because it's eating and sleeping and training, and it's like, this sucks, but Montreal is such a great city. Are you finding time to have some fun while you're up there? Are you enjoying Montreal?
Yeah, I actually do enjoy it, and partially because I actually love what I do. Like, yeah, the grind, it sucks. Like, you know, I only really hate the last week and a half of training camp because that's when the weight cut starts. But other than that, you know, I enjoy the grind. I enjoy going to practices. I feel like a kid in the game because I have so much to learn. You know, with 2.5 years in, that's like, as baby steps compared to how much knowledge I'm actually going to be learning. So, you know, every day I go into the gym, it's just like an eye opener for me. I'm learning new shit every day. So it's fun. And then the guys here are cool. You know, we try to you know, have some fun here. You know, on weekends we might go downtown just to walk around about, when I can't grab something to eat. So it's not too bad. It really reminds me of like a college setting. So I don't mind it. It's cool. Definitely great for my career. So definitely like that part of it.
I told you before, I'm so happy that you finally made the step up to find a real camp and moved yourself up to the TriStar. It honestly couldn't be better. And if you want to give yourself a shot in this sport and to be one of the guys at the top of the level and be one of the guys that everyone looks after, you have to do it. You have to be in a big camp and you got to be around people that have way more knowledge than you do. Does it get frustrating at all for you sometimes during practice when you're going against somebody that you're like, wow, this guy's like a really long-term seasoned veteran. This guy's been around for a long time. And he just, every day, he just kind of is a little bit faster than you. He's just kind of a little bit better positioned than you. He's just a little bit ahead of you the entire time. Does that frustrate you at all?
No. It actually motivates me. I like it. Like, you know, when I find a good partner up here that can push me, and, you know, like I say, we can do a spar, and, you know, one of the guys gets better of me that day, I make sure, and okay, next time we're going to go. Because, you know, if I don't beat you next time, and you beat me, I'm going to get better. If I beat you, it's good for me. You know what I mean? So I like it. You know, I'm a big believer in steel sharpens steel. You know, I'm a guy, if I get my ass whooped, I keep going back every day until I eventually whoop your ass, you know?
Yep, I know. Man, that's great, Daz. I'm really proud of you. I'm really happy for you two up there. It's going to be a great situation, and I can't wait to see this fight with Curt. This whole card for me, Titan Fighting Championships 33 on CBS Sports, March 20th, is a great card. I'm hoping I can convince Lex and the rest of the TFC guys to bring me in for this fight so I can watch it live. I want to be able to see this one live if I can down in Alabama.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, Dez, we have a great rest of the day. Stay warm up there. I know it's still cold up there in Montreal. Stay warm. We'll talk soon.
All right, thanks, bro. I'll see you.